I got the truth, you know, I never really wanted to get married again, you know, and that's where I was for a long time. And a lot of you brothers already, you guys knew that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they knew that. But you know what? As I gave you the truth, and you start getting built up, and you start learning scripts, and you're here in class after class, there's something that always got me. Give me Genesis 2:18.
Bring it up. Bring it up.
Bring it up. Bring it up. Bring it up.
The book of Genesis, chapter 2, and verse 18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him and help meet for him.
That's right. You know, and like I said, as I was getting built up and all the classes we went through, you know, the marriage classes, the proven classes, all these things, I've always heard that script. And that always put a doggone, just pinched my doggone spirit. You know? Because I was either thinking, well, let me see, I'm not keeping the commandments, or I'm just robbing myself of what the Most High has for me. You know?
Talk to me.
And so, you know, time goes by, and I got a story. It's funny. One day I was speaking to Captain Arye. We was talking some camp stuff and everything else. And he was asking a whole bunch of stuff. And all of a sudden I asked him, hey, bro, I think I want to get married. You know anybody? And yo, let me tell you, I ain't the most impulsive person, you know? And so he says, oh, you know, this, you know, Captain, you know, his whole countenance changed, you know? He was, oh, he says, oh, I got somebody. There's somebody I know. Good sister. She's been around for a while, put in mighty works. And I'm like, oh yeah, well, that sounds good. You know what I mean? It's promising. He says, I'll call you right back.
Bring it up.
Right? So you know, I got off the phone. I was like, what in the hell made me do that? I mean, I don't know where it came from. I mean, I'll be straight with you. I don't know where that came from.
Oh, crazy.
But anyway, it came out. So, you know, I'm like, okay, well, I'll go with it. So he calls me back, right? He says, hey, Galiah. He says, what's your government name? I said, Israel. And he says, oh, you changed your name. I said, yeah. You know, he says, well, that was the first question she asked. I said, oh, man, my sister, boy, she's serious about this thing.
That's right.
You know, so it was funny. You know, we got to know each other. We talked, right, all the time. It took us, well, it didn't happen immediately, but we eventually got to it, you know. And, you know, we got together, we talked, we started proving each other. And it was beautiful, you know? All the times, you know, you would sit there and you'd like, you know how you hear the bishop say, oh, you gotta see how she get when she get mad, you know? I'm still waiting. I'm still waiting. I know that ain't reality, but I'm still waiting. Give me Sirach 26 and 13 through 15.
The book of Sirach.
So hold on. So you know, with that attitude that I had, I knew it was wrong, right? And I knew I had, you know, I had to do something different. Come on.
The book of Sirach, chapter 26 and verse 13. The grace of a wife delighteth her husband, and her discretion will fatten his bones.
Hey, now who don't need that? Who don't need that? Stand up, sis.
Verse 14. A silent and loving woman is a gift of the Lord.
Hey, I threw some stuff at her, you know? And like I said, it, just for the purpose to see what her reaction is, I've never seen her mad, you know? And I'd like, damn, some of the things I wouldn't say nothing, not crazy now, don't get me wrong. But I've yet to see her get mad. And I pray I don't. But come on.
Verse 14. A silent and loving woman is a gift of the Lord. And there is nothing so much worth as a mind well instructed.
that's priceless. Absolutely priceless. And the reason why I say that, where it says a mind well instructed. Let me tell you about this system. I have never, in my time in the truth, to see anybody with three children in the truth.
That's right.
Three children in the truth. And when I say a mind well instructed, oh, and a son-in-law as well. So this whole family, hey, I'm joining a family that I'm happy to join.
That's right.
Lord will. But it's, you know what's funny about that? Some of you older folks in here, can you imagine being chaperoned by your children? Can you imagine being chaperoned by your children? We were going to behave ourselves. We were doing it right all the way through. But it was pretty doggone funny. We go there and we walk it down somewhere and all of a sudden you got a camera on it. And it's like FaceTime to everybody else. What the hell is this? You know? But come on, bro.
Verse 15. A shamefaced and faithful woman is a double grace, and her content mind cannot be valued.
Priceless. Give me verse 1 and 2.
Verse 1. Blessed is the man that hath a virtuous wife, for the number of his days shall be doubled.
Hey, double, can you imagine? Come on.
Verse 2. A virtuous woman rejoiceth her husband, and he shall fulfill the years of his life in peace.
Hey, that's what we all want. We all want to be happy. We all want to be in peace. And that's especially what I'm looking for. And I think I found that. Give me 25 and 1. And we'll wrap it up here.
The book of Sirach, chapter 25 and verse 1. In three things I was beautified and stood up beautiful both before God and men.
You knew this, right?
The unity of brethren. The love of neighbors, a man and a wife that agree together.
That's it. So,
go ahead.
It would be my pleasure if you would. Would you marry me? Y'all do me a favor. Huh? Tell them there was no crying here.
Referred
to me.
Shalom Israel, Most High in Christ. Blessed. This is a special message to Officer Get Alliance of South Carolina and Sister Elizabeth of Alabama. This is Captain Amaziah. I love you both. And I'm happy and I'm so proud of the both. Proud to be here and to celebrate your matrimony and you two spend the rest of your lives together in Christ. You know, so I'm happy to be here. We're about to do it big for your wedding. Atlanta's here. We got South Carolina here. We got Alabama here. We got North Carolina here. We're gonna do it big because you two deserve it, all right? You're both loyal to the mission. You're loyal to Christ. So I know you'll be loyal to each other. Most High Christ bless.
Hey, Shalom, Most High Christ bless. I'd like to wish best wishes to Officer Get Alliance, Sister Elizabeth, and a happy union. Hey, I wish you all the best. Hey, Most High Christ bless.
Hey, Shalom, Most High Christ bless. Hey, it's kind of funny, Officer Get Alliance, man. Me and you talked about this thing. It's kind of funny the day is here, but I'm happy for y'all, Sister Elizabeth, and Officer Get Alliance, man. I'm proud of y'all. Happy y'all did it the right way. Y'all been an example to everybody in IUIC Columbia. And, you know, we call you pops around here all together, like, you know, pops around here, you know. We're proud of you, man. Love you. Y'all, hey, best wishes and hey, most high Christ bless both of y'all for the rest of y'all life. Enjoy it. Have fun. Be kids, man. Be kids. Shalom. Most High Christ bless.
Hey, Shalom. Most High Christ bless. Hey, this is Officer Yuri out of South Carolina camp. We are here at Officer Gadalai's wedding feast. Concord, North Carolina. You know what I'm talking about? My bag is, hey, I'm South Carolina, so I said, but I correct myself. But hey, we out here enjoying the festivities. You know, we getting this fish ready. You know, my man, my soldier right here. Yo. Yo, he did his thing on that grill, though. You know what I'm talking about? Hey, that chicken is like, you know, up. Hey, that brother there. Woo! Hey, only thing I can say is, damn that chicken. Slump.
Shalom, my brother Ariel. I'm from headquarters in New York, and this is my nephew, Sonny. And we're here.
Shalom, Israel.
We're here for my brother's wedding with Elizabeth, and we just want them to have the greatest time, and all praises that the Lord brought them together, and we're just very excited about being a part of this wedding.
Hey, Shalom, Israel. It's Officer Nehemiah, IUIC Birmingham, Alabama. Just in town checking out the wedding, all right? We'll have a good time. Most High Christ bless.
Hey, Shalom, Israel. Most High in Christ bless. Welcome to the wedding feast of House of Gedaliah. Myself, I'm getting married to Sister Elizabeth Israel. We've been proven for over a year and a half now, and the day has finally arrived that we're going ahead and have this wedding feast, something that we both have been looking forward to. It's the day I've been waiting for since I've been in this truth. I met Sister Elizabeth through Captain Arie. I was on the phone with him one day, and I said, "Cap, you got somebody for me?" And he says, "Are you serious?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I'm serious." And he says, "Okay, I'll get back with you." Then he told me about Elizabeth, and I told him, "Hey, I'm great. All right, let me know." So he wanted to ask her, tell her about me, that I was interested in her. And that's how we got together. We started proving, and now it culminates up into this day. So it's been a nice betrothal period, and we're ready to do it. Shalom, Most High Christ bless.
Shalom, Israel, Most High Christ bless. Thank you for tuning into our wedding. Today is the wedding of Officer Gedaliah and Elizabeth Israel. We met over a year ago, and today is the big day. I'm excited, a little nervous. There's a lot of people out there. But if I could sum up this journey, it would be that man plans his way, but the Lord orders his steps. So thanks for coming along, and hopefully you'll enjoy the ceremony.
So at this time, we are going to start seating the bride and groom's family and special guests. I will need all the men to go ahead and line up first. We're going to go ahead and get you seated. Men of the groom and bride's family. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and get you seated first. All right. Also, the women from the bride and groom's family and special guests, we're going to go ahead and line you up as well.
There's nowhere else to go. There's nowhere else to be. I'm here in love with you. You know what's best for me. Reflections of myself, no shadows in the dark. You mold a light to me now. You say what's for my heart. That's why I'll always be in love with you. That's when we're going up, oh, going up, where we rise and fall. You know I'll always be in love with you, still, still. Oh, yeah. space for me, and the reflections of my mind.
Trumpets, up! Thank you.
Your wife is presenting you with a gift of gold.
Hey, that's what those old man's waiting for.
I'm super nervous.
Okay, congregation, we can be seated now as we await the service. Jesus Christ for allowing us to witness such a beautiful occasion, the holy matrimony between our officer Gedaliah and our beautiful sister Elizabeth, as we come together in holy matrimony. Oh, this is really beautiful. This is really beautiful. What we want to do at this moment is I want to read a couple of scriptures, and then we're going to get into the marriage. I want to start out with Matthew 18 and verse 3 for a reason, because we need to recognize, as we do recognize, that it is God's commandments that makes us a beautiful people. It is God's commandments that changes us into a righteous people, where we can lead by a good example, to be that proper example to our brothers and sisters that are still on the outside, that have not fully yet have seen the application of God's laws done in righteousness. So let's read that. We're going to read two scriptures, and then we're going to get into marriage.
Yes, sir. Matthew chapter 18 and verse 3. And said, verily I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children,
So the whole point of what the scripture is talking about is us converting to be what God wants us to be. So the conversion is done by God's laws. Let's read that. Psalms.
Psalms
19 and 7.
Chapter 19 and verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple.
So the Bible says that the law converts the soul. So that's what converts us into righteous brothers and sisters, men and women, and children, boys and girls. So this is what we're here to do, and this is the example that we want to set out, not only to you, but throughout the whole planet. Okay? Let's read Matthew 19 now.
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 5, and said, for this cause a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh.
This is the institution of marriage. Marriage is about man leaving his mother and father and cleaving to his wife, because the two of them will make one flesh. So let's get that part going. Read that again.
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 5. And said, for this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh.
And the two will make one flesh. This is holy matrimony. This is what God's looking for. The two shall be one flesh. So take this one. They are married. Hence the word marriage, which means the two becomes one. Altogether, life is absolutely beautiful that we are here to witness. We know that you are a pillar in this nation. You are a pillar in this truth. You represent righteousness all around you. And you head a congregation in Columbia, South Carolina. So it is absolutely wonderful and imperative that this be done, so that the people there can see how righteousness is done, so that they too can be inspired to do what we're doing here today.
Yes, sir.
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 6. Wherefore, they are no more twain.
The two of you are no longer separated. The two of you are no longer individuals. You two are married together to be one flesh, to think as one.
But one flesh. What? Therefore God have joined together.
This is what God has joined together. God has joined the two of you together. What it means by God joining them together, meaning that they both believe in this Bible. Whenever there's problems, because issues are going to come up in the marriage. There's going to be trials in the marriage. It's like the scripture say, there will be trouble in the flesh. But this is what puts the marriage and keeps the marriage together. So whenever there's issues on both sides, the trials are going to bring that. Whenever there's an issue or trials going on, you both, being that you are believers, you both consult the word of God to resolve the problems. Yes, sir. And outside of that, if there's any more edification that needs to come, that's why you have counselors. God set all of that up. So you are really in the good graces of God this day, right now.
Yes, sir.
What's the next scripture? Did we finish that? Let's finish that.
Matthew chapter 19 and verse 6. Wherefore they are no more twain, but one flesh. What therefore God hath joined together, let not man put asunder.
Let not man put asunder. Let not anything separate the two, because God put you together. And that's a beautiful thing to witness. I'm happy, particularly, just seeing the two of you come together and to see my nation come together in righteousness. This is what we need. We don't have enough of this out here in this world. So to actually see this come together in my eyesight and in my lifetime, and to see and it's being witnessed by all of us, it is truly a monumental, beautiful thing, and the angels are rejoicing at the same.
Tobit chapter 7 and verse 13. Then he called his daughter Sarah, and she came to her father, and he took her by the hand and gave her to be wife to Tobias.
That's what we did earlier, okay? The captain here gave her away, okay? This is the beautiful thing. Read that again.
Then he called his daughter Sarah, and she came to her father, and he took her by the hand and gave her to be wife to Tobias.
So gave my sister Elizabeth to our officer Gedaliah,
saying, behold, take her after the law of Moses, and lead her away to thy father. And he blessed them, and called Edna his wife, and took paper
and did write an instrument of covenants. Marriages consist of paperwork. Paperwork has been drawn up, signed, and they are legally married. And this is according to God. Society got that out of the Bible. And sealed it. And sealed it, meaning it is a document that documents that the two of you are married. This is a beautiful thing. You got the next scripture? You remember the sequence of them? Where are we going now?
Tobit.
8, what was it?
Tobit chapter 10.
10 and 12?
Yes, sir.
Read. Tobit chapter 10 and verse 12. And he said to his daughter, honor thy father and thy mother-in-law, which are now thy parents, that I may hear good report of thee. I'm certainly a parents that are here witnessing this wonderful occasion, and they don't want to hear bad report. They've painstakingly raised you up, and they want to see you go in the right direction, and they want to hear good report coming out of this marriage. And he kissed her. Edna also said to Tobias, the Lord of heaven restore thee, my dear brother, and grant that I may see thy children of my daughter Sarah before I die, that I may rejoice before the Lord. Behold, I commit my daughter unto thee of special trust. This is very important. Whenever we give our daughters away to husbands, we want to make sure that we're putting them in good hands. We don't want to hear any reports of abuse and this and that and the other. We don't tolerate that, and God don't tolerate that.
Sure.
You already know that, so I'm just bringing these things out for those of us that don't know. But he's a pillar in this truth, and he knows about what this Bible says. Wherefore, do not entreat her evil. That's the end of that, right? Wherefore, do not entreat the sister evil. There's going to be trials that's going to come up. Like we often discuss, issues are going to come up in the marriage, truck be the bills, be all kinds of things. And sometimes you can get pulled out of the spirit, and sometimes we get angry. The scriptures say, control your mind, control your thoughts, and subdue whatever emotions come, and consult counsel, consult the scriptures, so that we don't act out of what the scriptures say. So we remain in the laws of God. Next scripture.
1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 28. But if thou marry, thou hast not sinned. And if a virgin marry, she hath not sinned. Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh.
You see what Paul said? Paul said, nevertheless, there shall be trouble in the flesh. Just like we were speaking about earlier, this is going to come up. So trouble is going to come up. But when these troubles come up, consult the scripture and stay in the spirit.
But I spare you.
But I spare you, because marriage is a trial. It's a trial. It's a good thing to understand about marriage, which is another step in what we know as the trials of faith. New brothers and sisters come into the body. When they first come in, they're going through their own personal trial. That's one set of trials. Then you have trials in the congregation. Then you have marital trials. So each time you go through your trial, when you first get into that trial, you are a newborn baby. Give me that in Peter. First Peter 2 and 2. Because the objective in going into a trial is to learn from the trial and know how to behave while you're in the trial. Never come out of the spirit during your trial. Listen.
1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 2. As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word.
So as we journey into God's commandments, we become newborn babes with every new step of trial. When you first come in, you're a newborn baby. And then when you deal with brothers and sisters in the congregation, you're a newborn baby again. Now that you've gotten married, you're a newborn baby in a marriage. So in that marriage, trials are going to come up, and we have to endure just like we endured in the other two instances of our trials. That what? Read on.
1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 2. As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby.
So the objective of why I'm reading this scripture is about us growing together, learning each other. We're talking about two spirits coming together. That's going to take a process of learning each other even more than just the proving and getting to know each other, likes and dislikes and so forth. Now the two of you have become one flesh. That's a process. That's a trial. But in your trial, you are learning to grow together in righteousness. And Paul said he spares us in that growth.
because trouble will come up. But as men of God and as women of God, we know how to behave in our trials.
Yes, sir.
Y'all all right?
Yes, sir.
Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands.
So as we read about the responsibility of the husband is to take care of the wife, but that's coming up also, and to be responsible and not to treat her evil, my sister has a responsibility as well. Read that again.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything.
What's beautiful about this is that the wife is being subject to the husband because her husband is a righteous man. She's not being subjected to somebody that's going to be doing crazy things. No, because the scriptures don't tolerate that. Being that he's in righteousness, she is to follow him in righteousness. And that's what's going to bring a righteous nation. This is what we need. And this is why this is beautiful to behold. Okay. Captain Amazon, you had some things that you wanted to bring up?
Yes, sir.
You can take my mic.
Shalom, everybody. Most High in Christ bless. Most High in Christ bless. Happy to be here. Officer Gedaliah, my brother. Sister Elizabeth, my sister. I've known these two for a long time now. Both of them, long time. Excellent spirit on both of them. Loyal. Both of them, very loyal. So they're loyal to Christ, so I know they'll be loyal to each other.
That's right.
Give me that script. Where you at? First Peter 2. I'm going to go through a couple of scripts with the both of you to show you marriage and things that's going to happen in marriage. 1 Peter 3 and 1.
Yes, sir.
1 Peter chapter 3 and verse 1. Likewise, ye wives, be in subjection to your own husbands.
So the scripture says, be in subjection to your own husband. This is in righteousness, not in evil. In righteousness, be subject to your own husband. Go ahead.
That if any obey not the word, they also may without the word be won by the conversation of the wives.
Because guess what? In a marriage, as Deacon brought out, marriages, there's going to be issues. There's going to be problems. No marriage is perfect. Don't let nobody lie to you. No marriage is perfect. But if you have an issue with your Lord, you can win him over just by your countenance, by your behavior towards him, by what comes out of your mouth towards him. Remember, the scripture says, a soft answer turneth away wrath. Okay? So you can still be able to win your husband over. Go ahead.
Verse 2. While they behold your chaste conversations coupled with fear, whose adorning let it not be that outward adorning.
See that the scripture says, you know, this is a beautiful garment, absolutely beautiful. The scripture says, don't let your righteousness be the outside of your garment, your clothing, your hair, your jewelry. Go ahead.
Whose adorning let it not be that outward adorning of plaiting the hair, and of wearing of gold, or of putting on of apparel. But let it be the hidden man of the heart.
Let it be the hidden man of the heart. God that's inside of you. Go ahead.
And that which is not corruptible, even the ordinance of a meek and quiet spirit.
Even the ordinance of a meek and quiet spirit. This is the absolute opposite of what our sisters are in the world today. Meek and quiet. By your behavior, you can win your husband back over. Go ahead.
Which is in the sight of God of great price.
Great price. That's a great price in the sight of God for a sister to be have a meek and humble spirit. Not loud, not bumping chests with the husband and so forth. Go ahead.
For after this manner, in the old time, the holy woman also, who trusted in God, adorned themselves, being in subjection unto their own husband.
God said it again, be in subjection to your own husband. Go ahead.
Even as Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord, whose daughters ye are, as long as ye do well.
See that? It says, as long as you're doing the commandments of God, you a daughter of Sarah. That's what God said. Go ahead.
And are not afraid with any amazement. Likewise, ye husbands.
Now, Officer Gedaliah, my brother.
Yes, sir.
leader of South Carolina, right? Got it.
Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge.
That knowledge is you're supposed to dwell with your wife according to God's laws. God said, don't entreat the sister Eve. Got it.
Giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel.
Scripture says, give honor to her as the weaker vessel. Okay, go ahead.
And as being heirs together.
See that? It says, you two now, now that you're one flesh, you are heirs together. You're not separate no more. Not two spirits no more. Now you have, you're joining two spirits together for the rest of your life. You understand? You are heirs together. You're going to get the kingdom together. Go ahead.
And as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers be not hindered.
That your prayers be not hindered. Go ahead.
Finally, be ye all of one mind.
Be ye all of one mind. See when them trials come up in your marriage? You guys have to now be able to work that out. Be of the same mind and same spirit. Remember, the scripture says endeavor to keep the unity. That goes with marriage too. It just doesn't go for the congregation like we all use that scripture for, but it also goes with your marriage. All right?
Finally, be ye all of one mind, having compassion one of another.
See that? Compassion. That's what black people lack. We lack compassion for each other. We know that. Right? Go ahead.
Love as brethren.
Love as brethren.
Be pitiful.
Be pitiful. What is this talking about? Have mercy on each other. Read.
Be courteous. Not rendering evil for evil.
Not rendering evil for evil.
Or railing for railing.
Arguments.
But counterwise, blessing.
Because you want a blessing. Go to the next clip. What's the next one?
1 Corinthians 7.
1 Corinthians 7 and 3.
1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 3. Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence.
Benevolence.
Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence.
Benevolence. What is this talking about? This is talking about laying down with your wife. Let the husband render due benevolence unto his wife, right?
Benevolence.
Now the brother messed me up. How is this? Good. Yeah, we don't want to mess that up, right? Brother's been waiting forever now. Come on. What's wrong with you? I got one brother waiting.
And likewise, also, the wife unto the husband. The wife has not power of her own body.
Wait. I missed something. Read it again. Verse 3.
Let the husband render unto the wife due benevolence.
Read.
And likewise, also, the wife unto the husband.
All right, and likewise, the wife unto the husband. Because what is the definition of marriage? Marriage is supposed to be constantly, what do you call it again? How is it in the Bible dictionary? Consecrated, right. Consecrated by what? Sex. Consummated. Do sex, right? Do benevolence. That's what it's all about. Do benevolence. Go ahead.
The wife has not power of her own body.
See that? Sister, you don't have power over that body no more, right? The husband got power over that body. Go ahead.
But the husband.
See, the husband got power.
And likewise, also, the husband has not power of his own body.
You ain't got power over your body either.
But the wife.
The wife has power over your body now.
Captain,
can I
get something?
Yes. Yes, I know you want to. No. Only because we're at this particular subject. We come back and we give it back to you, Captain. Give me Hebrews 13 and 4. There's a reason why I want this, because as we were reading what God said concerning the power of our own bodies. We as men don't have the power over our own body when it comes to the wife when she wants to do benevolence. Same thing with the sister. I don't feel like giving it up. No.
Get a pop of aspirin.
Huh? Y'all all right? Okay. So God is telling us how to behave in this regard. But let me read the flip side of that thing. Because when the couple is married, all of this is ordained by God. When there is no marriage by law, meaning paperwork, it is against God to do any of this. That's what we're about to read now. And I thought it was important that we interject this as we're reading about
benevolence.
Let's get that thing right. Come on. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all. Wait a minute. marriage is honorable in all. Not boyfriend and girlfriend. That's the reason why I wanted to read this. Not this stuff that they have out here in society. No, God says marriage is honorable. We just read what the definition of God's marriage is. Marriage is honorable in all aspects of marriage. Go ahead. And the bed undefiled. And the bed is undefiled because the two that's in that bed, man and woman, are married. Okay. Anything else outside of that, the scriptures call it an unlawful bed. Okay. Read it again. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers take place in an unlawful bed. That's what the scriptures is talking about. So when you come together in marriage, your bed is lawful. So that's when you get it on. Read it again. Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God will judge. God says he will judge whoremongers and adulterers because they're not married and they are in an unlawful bed. And God says he's not with that. So I needed to have that read as we are continuing to read about a lawful bed and what is ordained by God. And as a matter of fact, it is ordained and encouraged that you do that thing.
Yes, sir.
Because it's lawful.
Yes, sir. Oh, praise to the Most High. Go back to verse 4. Where you at, 5?
Yes, sir.
1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse 5. Defraud ye not one the other.
So you can't defraud one another. Still talk about the due benevolence. Go ahead.
Except it be with consent.
Benevolence.
Defraud ye not one the other. Except it be with consent for a time.
Except it be with consent for a time. Got it.
That ye may give yourselves to fasting and prayer.
That's when it's not lawful to lay with your wife, when you're giving yourself to fasting and prayer. Go ahead.
And come together again.
And see that? And come together again. Go ahead.
That Satan tempt you not.
Because what can happen in a marriage when you're defrauding one another? Brothers might eyes start wandering, sisters' eyes might start wandering. Go ahead.
Satan tempt you not for your incontinency.
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 Let's go to the next word. Ecclesiastes 9 and 9. Let's go there. Ecclesiastes 9 and verse 9. So what you guys are really witnessing here is the new standard in society. That's what you're witnessing. Okay? Because the standard we've had in society is what? Boyfriend and girlfriend, baby mamas, baby daddies. No. Our minds are changing now. We're not doing those things no more. Some things have to stop. All right? Let's go.
Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 9. Live joyfully with the wife whom thou lovest all the days of the life.
See that? It says live joyfully. It didn't say live joyfully with your baby mama, with your girlfriend. It says live joyfully with your wife. Go ahead.
Of thy vanity, which he have given thee under.
Which who gave you? God gave you. Gave this woman to you. Okay, this is ordained of God right here. All right? All praises for God using Captain REA to set you two up together.
Sir.
All praises for Most High for that. Go ahead.
Which he hath given thee under the sun all the days of thy vanity, for that is thy portion in this life.
That's your portion in this life. You are his portion in this life. Okay? So y'all gotta not defraud one another. Don't treat the sister evil. You don't treat him evil. Go ahead.
And in thy labor which thou takest under the sun.
Because you have a heavy responsibility. You're the leader of that camp over there. So the standard you set today, guess what? Now everybody else down there can follow you now. Follow your standard and follow my sister right here. I don't think y'all realize the example that you're setting here. Y'all gotta really realize that thing. Go to the next one. 26 and 8, Genesis. So you're going to have to do what? Even though you have that heavy responsibility, now you have even more responsibility. You understand? You're going to have to now take care of this sister and live joyfully with her. You're going to have to set aside time for the sister. And likewise, the same way like for you, likewise. Go ahead.
Genesis chapter 26 and verse 8. And it came to pass, when he had been there a long time, that Abimelech, king of the Philistines, looked
out at a widow.
So this is a heathen here. He's looking out, right? Looking out at the window.
At a window, and saw, and behold, Isaac was sporting with Rebekah.
What was Isaac doing with his wife?
Sporting with Rebekah.
See that? He was having a good time with your, with his wife. There's nothing wrong with a brother having a good time with his wife. You know, we in the true, we soldiers of the Lord, but most of the time, we don't really, you know, interact like that in front of other brothers or the congregation or whatever the case may be. The Bible says, listen, he sported with Rebekah. Our forefathers sported. All right, read it again.
Isaac was sporting with Rebekah, his wife. Genesis chapter 26 and verse 8. And it came to pass, when he had been there a long time, that Abimelech, king of the Philistines, looked out of a window and saw, and behold, Isaac was sporting with Rebekah, his wife.
He was sporting. He was having a good time. He wasn't ashamed of his wife. Okay? Go to the next one. Give me Sirach 40 and 23. Oh, 26 and 1. Give me Sirach 26 and 1 first. Sirach 26 and 1. Two more scripts and I'm done. All praise.
Sirach chapter 26 and verse 1. Blessed is the man that have a virtuous wife.
Read it again.
Blessed is the man that have a virtuous wife.
I want you to really let that sink in there. Sis. So far from what I've seen you on, you are that virtuous woman. So blessed is that. Read it again.
Blessed is the man that have a virtuous wife.
Read on.
For the number of his days shall be doubled.
See that? That's heavy right there.
All praise.
You need that thing right there.
Yes, sir.
You need that thing. That brother's day is going to be double if he picks the right wife.
That's crazy.
Read it again.
Sirach chapter 26 and verse 1. Blessed is the man that has a virtuous wife, for the number of his days shall be double.
The number of that brother's days shall be double. His wife is going to know what to cook him to eat, to make him, keep him healthy. She's going to know when he needs a back rub, when his feet hurt, or whatever the case may be. She's going to know how to take care of that man. Right? Sirach 42, 40 and 23, I think it is.
Yeah,
40 and 23. Last script. I think that's the last one. 40 and 23. So once again, I'm honored to be here with the both of you. I know both of you a long time. You've both been loyal. I don't have a bad word to say about you both. You two are awesome.
That's
right.
Yes.
Sirach, chapter 40 and verse 23. A friend and a companion never meet amiss, but above both.
But above both. So a friend and a companion never meet amiss. But above that.
But above both is a wife with her husband.
A wife with her husband is above anything. That's your best friend right there. All right? That's my time.
All praise.
And with that, you may kiss your bride now. Of course, you're going to lead us off with the first dance, right?
pray to the Most High God.
Get the kingdom in love. Keep commandments in love.